Our mouth is the reflection of our overall health. It is said that your oral health is the mirror of your internal body. Do you remember how when you went to a doctor, he would straight away ask you to stretch the tongue out? This is because mouth is connected to various organs of the body through a network of veins. So for optimal health, it is extremely important to maintain proper oral hygiene. However, most people on a daily basis are knowingly or unknowingly doing things which is spoiling their teeth and gums. As a result, plaque, tooth decay, bleeding gums, bad breath, cavities, tooth sensitivity are common problems today. Research also suggests that a major chunk of people take oral care lightly, due to which these problems are on the rise. But the good news is that over 90% of the oral diseases can easily be prevented. So in this video, I have comprehensively discussed what we should do and what we should not do to keep our teeth shining and gums strong. Stay tuned. Hello friends, welcome to FitTuber. Maintaining a proper oral hygiene not only makes you more likable but also takes care of your overall health. In this video, I will discuss 5 common habits that lead to oral problems and 5 best habits that will revive back your oral health. Starting with the worst habits, number 5, using a toxic toothpaste. Which toothpaste do you use? Colgate, Pepsodent, Close-Up. It's sad that most popular toothpaste in the Indian market have toxic chemicals, especially sodium lauryl sulfate. If you regularly battle with mouth ulcers, it could be due to SLS in your toothpaste. Did you know that sodium lauryl sulfate has been registered as an insecticide and is not even recommended to be used in cosmetics, let alone toothpaste? But most companies are using it. Regular usage of SLS-based toothpaste may lead to its deposit in the heart, liver, lungs and brain. Then if your toothpaste has fluoride, be careful. Surely dentists recommend it, but you should know that ingesting just 2.8 grams of fluoride can kill a 50 kg adult. So if you have kids, then be cautious because they tend to ingest the toothpaste. Better switch to herbal toothpaste which are SLS and fluoride free. Number 4, brushing just after meals. Many people, as a part of healthy oral care routine, tend to brush their teeth right after meals, especially after dinner. Although little do they know that they are actually attacking their teeth. When we eat a meal, the acid levels in our mouth increases. Brushing just after can be damaging. Even soft bristled toothbrushes can be highly abrasive when the enamel is already weakened by the high acid levels. But your body has a natural way of correcting the high acid levels in the mouth and return it to proper pH through saliva, which is basic in nature. This takes about 30 minutes. So the next time, make sure that you brush after at least 30 minutes of a meal. Number 3, brushing the wrong way. Dentists advise to brush twice a day. But are you brushing the right way? A survey suggested that 89% of the people brush the wrong way. Brushing your teeth is no rocket science, but a variety of problems are tied to wrong brushing technique. First of all, always use a soft bristled brush. Hard bristle brush can damage the delicate gum tissue. Then use only pea-sized toothpaste. Anything more than that is wasted. Brushing should always be done in a circular motion, not horizontally, not back and forth. Brushing should be done slowly, taking the brush to every corner of the mouth. Vigorously brushing won't remove the bacteria, it may rather remove the enamel. So don't rush when you brush. Then most people do not brush more than 30 seconds. 2 minutes is ideal. Then make sure to replace your brush every 3 months. So these small tips can take your oral health to the next level with almost zero extra effort, isn't it? Number 2, not cleaning the tongue. Cleaning the tongue is as important as brushing the teeth. If you miss out on cleaning your tongue, you are more likely to face bad breath, more plaque, more bacteria in your mouth. Tongue can be cleaned either using a wet brush or a scraper. But the more effective and traditional method is to use a scraper. According to our traditions and Ayurvedic literature, tongue scraper should be made of copper, silver, gold, tin or brass. Copper is used as an effective bacteria-resistant metal since ancient times, and hence using it to clean the tongue adds to its benefits. So I highly recommend you to invest in a copper scraper rather than a plastic one. Number 1, toothpicking. Do you have a habit to toothpick after meals? If yes, then you should try and overcome this habit as it is bad, really bad for your teeth. Regular toothpicking can lead to an increase in the spaces in between your teeth. Toothpicking can also damage the gums, leading them to bleed. In certain cases, it can even break off in your mouth, causing oral infections. So avoid it. Tooth and gum is a sensitive area. Nail biting, chewing pen, pencils, or using your teeth as a toolbox is not recommended. So these were those 5 common habits that affect your oral health adversely. Now let's discuss 5 best habits. Number 5, rinsing the mouth after meals. If you want to increase the life of your teeth and gums, this is one of the best habits that you should inculcate. Every time you eat something, drink something, make sure that you go and wash your mouth. Washing your mouth does not mean you simply rinse in a few seconds and come. Spend 10 to 15 seconds properly swishing the water in the mouth before spitting it out. I would suggest you to link it with washing hands. Fill your mouth with water before applying soap on hands and let both the things be done simultaneously. Really try it out. You will be amazed to see how small particles of food which otherwise would have caused cavities will be flushed out. Number 4, oil pulling. Oil pulling is an ancient Indian technique to flush out the toxins present in the mouth. Every morning on an empty stomach, put a tablespoon of oil in your mouth. Swish it in and around the mouth for at least 10 to 15 minutes. When you are oil pulling, you can read a book, cook your food, pack your bag, or do whatever else you want to. Then spit the oil out. This oil will bring out toxins not only from the mouth but also other parts of the body. This is because an osmotic pressure is created, and since oil has the property to attach with itself dirt and microorganisms, when we spit the oil out, the toxins are flushed out as well. Oil pulling is a panacea for almost all oral health problems. You just name it. Moreover, it naturally gives you white teeth, fresher breath, pink lips and gums. So you need not depend on that costly so-called teeth whitening equipment available in the Indian market. Which oil to use, you may ask. You can use any cold pressed oil, but taking it a bit deeper, if you have digestive disorders like gas, bloating, dry skin, use sesame oil. If you have bleeding gums, go for coconut oil. If your tongue remains white due to excess mucus formation, use mustard oil. If you're suffering from serious tooth cavities, use sesame oil with 2 to 3 drops of clove oil mixed in it. Number 3, start using dant manjan. It's good to brush, but if you want to take your oral care routine to the next level, then start cleaning your teeth using a dant manjan. Why? Because of its amazing benefits. Dant manjan or tooth powder is made using 100% most effective herbs for oral hygiene. Plus, dant manjan is done using massaging the gums with fingers. Now, this massaging the gums is what makes this technique so advanced. You will be amazed to know that our gums are directly connected to the intestines through a network of veins. When we massage the gums, it activates the intestines and they effectively produce more enzymes to digest the food. At least at night, before sleeping, skip brushing and clean your teeth using a tooth powder. You will notice that your digestion has improved, and as a result, you will have better oral health. It's cost effective too and has absolutely no side effects. Number 2, food and exercise for your teeth. Just like you exercise your other body parts, it's very important that you exercise your teeth as well. Exercising the teeth is the easiest. All you need to do is chew, which not many of us do these days, isn't it? Chewing the food properly makes the teeth stronger, no doubt. Although chewing the food does not mean that you keep binge eating on sweets, chips, burgers and chow mein. Such sugary and high starchy foods have the tendency to attract more bacteria, leading to cavities. Some foods which can really make your teeth stronger are sugarcane and walnuts. Generally speaking, eat wholesome foods. Vitamin C rich foods, calcium rich foods and probiotic rich foods are considered best for oral health. But again, make sure to chew them properly. Taking chewing further, number 1, use twigs. Twigs or dhatuns are probably the best exercise for the teeth and gums as it uniformly circulates the blood. This age-old formula is unbeatable. The barks of trees like neem and babool have strong antimicrobial properties, which is effective in fighting germs, maintaining the alkaline levels in your saliva, keeping bacteria at bay, treating swollen gums, preventing plaque, and also giving you whiter teeth. Today, companies are leveraging on their miraculous benefits by simply marketing their products in their name. It might not be a very practical option in the modern era to chew twigs daily, although I do recommend that you try and chew on them on Sundays. I believe you can easily find a neem tree in your vicinity. If not, you can always buy them online. So getting over these worst habits and inculcating these best habits, I guarantee you will be able to say goodbye to all your oral health problems. And you will have much more stronger teeth, gums, fresher breath, and a beautiful confident smile to wear. I want to thank ProBurst for partnering with us for this video. Proper oral hygiene demands proper diet, and if you are looking for an authentic whey protein supplement, one good option in the Indian market is ProBurst's Whey Protein Supreme. It is a blend protein made from whey protein concentrate and isolate sourced from the United States. If you are a man or woman who works out regularly, then you can definitely put your hands on it. ProBurst's Whey Protein comes in different flavors, but the coffee flavor is their USP. For best results, have one scoop of it post-workout with water. ProBurst's one scoop will give you 24 grams of high quality protein, 5.5 grams of PCAA, and just 3 grams of carbs. Since you can buy the whey protein directly from the company, you can be assured that the product is not duplicate. ProBurst's whey protein has an added advantage as digestive enzymes are added to avoid bloating problems. To buy ProBurst's authentic whey protein supreme, click on the link down in the description box. So friends, that's all for this video. I hope you found it to be helpful. If yes, then please show me your support by giving this video a big thumbs up. What next would you like to see in this series? Comment your ideas below. You can now support my work on Patreon so that I can bring more well-researched videos for you. Please do remember to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so that you never miss a video from me. You can also follow me on Instagram. My name is Vivek. I thank you so much for watching.